Brashear in the Detroit zone on the backhand, cuts the net, scores! What a goal! Donald Brashear has made it.
Tell me about your childhood and how you first started to get involved with the game of hockey.
I was 8 years old. I started to skate at 8 years old. I didn't know how to skate or anything, and I took some skating lessons for a couple of years, and then I started to play. I remember going to school and they were asking me, what do you want to do later, what do you want to be? And I was always writing hockey player, I mean, and you know, you always hear people saying, oh, you don't have a chance, you know, it's too hard and this and that. And that was sort of the challenge for me.
Tell me about the road that you took to the NHL.
I went to the draft and I didn't get drafted, and I mean, my parents were there and stuff, and that was the deception for me. But after, I mean, the teams, next day the teams start calling me, and when they called me, they said, we want to offer your contract and everything. That was awesome. Like, I mean, it was almost better than being drafted.
Now, since coming to the Canucks, you've been put in a lot of different situations, being able to showcase your skills a little bit more. What has that meant to you?
I love them doing my job and doing the fighting, and I know that's my job. But with all the new rules and stuff, if you want to play for a while in this league, you got to learn how to play hockey. And I always want to develop some skills. And when you get the chances and things are going well, I mean, that's the best way that it can happen.
Tell me about the game February 21st against the Boston Bruins, and what do you remember from that night?
He got really, probably got really pissed off. I mean, we fought a lot, me and him, and we had a few tilts. And I mean, I think most of the time I had the best of him, and that's a respect. And in front of your teammates and stuff, you know, you lose respect. I mean, I fell on the goalie, and the goalie got hurt, and they probably thought I did it on purpose. And I mean, a few things, and I mean, I was bugging them, you know, how you try to make the team lose their focus and everything. So I was in front of their bench bugging them too, and so all these things, I mean, probably, you know, built up, but I still don't understand, you know, what happened, why did it get that bad, you know.
How did you feel when you first saw the tape of the incident?
It was weird because I didn't remember at all, and I haven't seen it. And the way people were talking, you know, it looked really bad. And you know, you always think people would put a little more. And so I wanted to see it. And when I saw it, I was like, Jesus, it was a lot worse than I thought it was.
What are your thoughts on the suspension that was handed down by the league on Marty McSorley?
This was more like he really tried to injure me, and I mean, I could have died. I don't think this guy should be playing in the league anymore, you know, after things like that. I mean, how bad does it have to be, does it have to get before they decide, you know, what if I would have died, you know? I don't think the decision is good.
Now, do you accept the apology from Marty?
I'll never understand how he got to the point where he would hit me in the head with a stick. I had my back turned, and so that's what I really didn't like, and it's hard for me to accept his apology for that, you know.
Why has this season been your best season in terms of stats?
A couple of years ago, I was the most penalized in the league, and just got some tips from different players and about, you know, like playing my role. And just by playing my role and being the most penalized guy, you know, I think I earned some respect, and that's what really helped me gain my confidence. And then I was out there, and I was having a lot more room, and that's a big key for me. If I have room, I mean, I think I have decent skills where I can make a pass or, you know, I make a play sometimes. So the more time I get, the better it is.
Here he scores.
Seems like a lot of teams for training camp now are heading overseas and stuff like that. Do you think that's a good idea?
It's pretty good because it helps push the game around the world.
You know, we usually go anyway.